That seems to be like part of my intro now every time. Come on now. Come on. Come on. Come on there. So, let me back up. So this bob that I cut is from a company called Miss By Beauty. Mm-hmm. I'm going to read all of the specs for you guys and all of that good stuff so that you guys can see how I came about this, because it did not come like this. So this is a lace front unit. So I only have lace from here to here. And then, you know, on the sides, you guys know, it creeps up on you. So I'm not really getting much lace on the sides. It's enough to do what you gotta do. But originally what I was gonna do was I was gonna cut the combs out of this and I was gonna make it like a, I wanted to do like a two-tone ponytail and like a half up, half down two-tone ponytail. Not sure if I'm still gonna do that, but it was the idea for something that I hadn't done before. Then I ran into one of you guys, one of my subscribers. I was at Target. Like, if y'all know anything about me, y'all know I love me some Dr. J, okay? So I went to Target and she was like, I love all your hairstyles, but is there any way you can do something that's a more adult friendly, where pretty much, girl, not ponytails, not this, because she worked in corporate America and she wanted something where she could wear her weaves and her wigs and all those things, but she just didn't want it to look like she was trying too hard and she didn't want it to look childish. So I said, okay, I got you, girl. So I was like, well, what do you want? Like, I was like, I'm done bobs, I've done short looks, what do you want? She's like, I just want something that you've done but kind of revamped, something like it's futuristic, you know, head be in charge. And I'm just like who, Miss Jetson? And she was like, that would be cute. So Jane Jetson was, we're gonna put a picture of her here. Jane Jetson was my inspiration for this look. I loved her hair color. I was gonna use like a orangier color, but then I was like, then that's still not wearable. Like, she said wearable, fool. Don't go out and get blazing orange or blaze orange and think that you're gonna be able to, cause you're not. No, you're not. So I came up with this, which is a nice layered moment. So I'll go ahead and do this. Nice nasty bob, as somebody put on my Instagram. So yeah, I just went, I was like, I want something that I could wear every day. And mind you, my hair yesterday when I did this for the first time and it didn't work.
If I could explain to y'all how my makeup turned into the black swan, it would be the longest conversation, and Snapchat is a little too late for that. So I have to, okay, I'm done. Good night.
Workout was way more voluminous than this, but I slept in this wig and it actually held up with the shower, y'all. And I like my showers like knock you out hot. So the fact that baby stayed after I wrapped it was actually good. But I slept on it and this side is kind of coming up because I used the Got to Be Glue spray, so it's not like a permanent hold. It's more like a hold, like it holding for the moment. It does this, it holds it down. But yeah. So let me give you guys the specs on it and then give you our experience with the bleaching, the coloring, and everything in between. So for clarity, let me make sure I put, this is their 13x6 lace front deep part wig. So that's why the fact that the part goes so far back, which I love, you guys know I love that, and that's my only, with lace, you guys know I can't stand lace front wigs like that. But when I seen that it was the 13x6, I was like, I ain't never had that before, okay? I'm trying to nuisance them, see what that'd be like. So, I will say that I do enjoy the parting space of it. It was originally a 1B. It is 150 density, which you can tell there's no added tracks in here. All of this body and this movement is natural. And I believe that my original length, because I cut it as soon as I got it, was, I believe, 20 or 22 inches. I don't believe my hair was on 24, though, but we chop babies real tough. I ended up doing was I went ahead and bleached it, and I got it to, like, it was, like, a 4 in some places, and then it was, like, a lighter 2 in other places. Once I got it to that, I took Adore's color in Spiced Amber. I believe that's the, I think I only use one color, which is Spice Ander, because, I spiced amber because once I colored it, I colored it where it had some highlights and lowlights in it already, so I could use one color. It kind of would make it, and it pretty much makes it two colors. So if you go ahead and you bleach it and you go ahead and do highlights and then you put one color on top of it, the highlights would then turn into lowlights and highlights of one color but two different dimensions, if that makes any sense. And then I went ahead and I conditioned it, I washed it, and yeah, clearly, I didn't just condition and wash it and then end up with this. I cut it and I made sure that I cut it into a style, like I said, which once it's curled, it will curl extremely well and it have a lot of body and a lot of movement so that you can see the amount of body as well as the density that was in the hair. Shedding, good. You guys, I don't really have many issues with shedding when it comes down to my wigs. I have it more so with hair. So that was good to know. Shedding was cool. Tangling, I get none. I mean, girl, I can't say how long it is when it's long does it tangle, because I haven't. But with this, she's bouncing and behaving, for sure. Now, When it comes to one thing that I don't like about this wig, and that's why it's gonna take it from a 10 and turn it into an 8, because they put combs in here, which I totally am not against. Combs are great, especially when you have braids. I don't wear braids anymore. We just do the whole flat iron and then we go about our day, but that's another story. So I was shocked to see that, and I'll put pictures here, that there were these very awkwardly placed plastic tabs that were over the combs. Now, I get it. We are doing a lot of tension, we're doing a lot of pulling. You want to make sure that after a while that your lace does not tear. That is the main thing that you do not want to happen. Once your lace tears, it's pretty much done. So I decided, because I told you guys I was going to do a different look in the beginning of this, right? Okay. I tried to go cut the plastic off. That was a fail. And then I tried to go ahead and take the combs out, which I ended up getting out, but that was a fail as well. So I have a half comb in, half comb out. My lace on this side is tore. And I just want to say, because this wig is so good and because everything else about it is so great, take the combs out. And if you're going to put the combs in, either put them in the box and make them optional, or don't put them in there at all. Because here's one side. One side is, if you're a person who plans to get the wig and wear it as it originally is, that's great. And you don't plan to do no manipulation besides put it on your head, go to work, go do what you got to do and call it a day. It's great. Now, when you got somebody like me who wants to be, you know, the jack of all trades, and I want to try different things, it's very difficult to bleach knots when there are two big combs in the way. Because where those combs are, the bleach will not get to. Especially if you got this big plastic band that's going to put all this condensation up in it after you rinse it with super duper warm water. So I don't like that. That's one thing that really just took me out the gate. I was like, really? But the stitching of my actual tracks in here are extremely good. Hold on. I don't know if you could tell. But yeah, these are what the tracks look like in the back, which is not bad. They're very, very, very thin. I like, because that way my hair can sit very, very, very flat, you know? And it was very easy to cut. I didn't have any issues with cutting. I didn't have any issues with the flow. I didn't have any issues with the color. The only thing I don't like, Miss Bai, is those combs. And even if you put the combs, just take the plastic part off. Because that part for customization, which most of us do not take our wigs right out the box and pop them on our heads. We will customize them and do the whole thing. I didn't really I didn't really do too much plucking with this, just because I wanted it to have a more of a fuller look like the cartoon was. I wanted it to have that very full, not drag animated, because that sometimes that gets a little weird, you know, when it's too thick. But I wanted it full enough up in here where it just wasn't super thin, especially because of the color. So, like I said, out of a 10, I would give them an 8 because of those damn combs. Those combs drove me up the wall, okay? And I was so, soon as I seen that my lace has split I wanted to cry, okay? I'm not gonna lie to you. I wanted to weep like a baby that was just born. So, like I said, I haven't had any issues with this. This is my, I get a lot of compliments on this wig. When I put it up on Instagram yesterday, people were like, that's a nasty bob. And I like these. You know, I don't do them often just because I find that they are overdone. But I've never seen one, at least I haven't seen one in a while, in this color. You know, and it gives you, I like in the fact, you know, that you can bust one of these and give them all of that, you know, realness. All look at that line, girl. Look at that line. Look at that line. Look at that line. So, you guys know I have no sense. And it's been a while, so I miss you guys. But yeah, another tip too. Don't want to glue down your wigs and you don't want to do all of that mess. Just use the Gossipy Glue spray and you can move this baby around. Hold on. There you go. Oh, come on now. Just make sure you put your lace down, okay? And you could do this, and then you pull her back. I like her back. And there you go. So again, I will put all the information for this below. And I hope you guys catch me on the next one. What y'all think about this? Should I do this in like blonde? Should I do it in color? Would you like to see it in black? Would you like to see it as a giveaway? I got, you know, a video a day in May is coming up, girl. And you know I got a lot of wigs to give away. Oh, yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, like I said. And I will catch y'all in my next one. Peace.